Yes, they are. Otherwise, it would be pointless if the salvation body had soul.
If they had an illusion like that when they were chosen for the prince's watch, the prince would have thought it would be too good for them.
We'll give them the assignment, Sir Dogbert.
First watchman, which do you think is the most deserving to be the leader of the watch?
It would either be Hugh Oakcake or George Seagull, sir, because they can both be in line.
Come, Sir Seagull. God has blessed you with a good name. To be good looking is a matter of luck, but to read and write is a natural gift.
Both of which, Master Constable?
You have. I knew that would be your answer. For your good looks, thank God, but don't boast about it. As for your reading and writing, use those skills and you can't use your looks. You were thought to be the most senseless and fit man here. You will carry the lantern and be constable. This is your assignment.
You will comprehend any vagrant man you see and order him to stop in the prince's name.
And what if he won't stop, sir?
Well then, you can leave him alone, gather the rest of your watch, and thank God that you got rid of such a criminal.
If he won't stop when he is told to, he isn't one of the prince's subjects.
True, and you weren't supposed to meddle with anyone but the prince's subjects.
You've always been known as a merciful man, partner.
True. I wouldn't even take a dog, for I have more than a man with honesty in him.
If you hear a child crying at night, call the nurse and tell her to quiet the child.
And what if she doesn't hear us?
Well then, leave quietly and let the child's crying wake up the nurse. The ear that doesn't wake up her lamb when it baas will never tend to another child.
That is very true.
If you meet a thief, you can expect him to be dishonest. The less you have to do with that kind of man, the more honest you'll be.
So, if we meet a thief, do we arrest him?
Your position permits you to. But I think that those who stick their hands in the ditch get their hands dirty. So, if you can't encounter a thief, I think the most peaceful thing to do is to let him be himself and steal away.
No, by all means, I don't think he can.
You, Constable, are representing the prince. If you meet the prince, you can order him to stop.
Bali, I think that's true.
I'll bet any man 5 shillings to 1 of it that he can stop the prince with his consent. For the watch shouldn't offend anyone, but it's an offense to keep a man without his consent.
That's also very true.
Well, good night, gentlemen. If you find anything important, find me and let me know. Or keep your secrets on your own. Come, friend.
Well, you're still on the bench until 2, and then I'll play.
One more thing, gentlemen. Watch over Signor Leonardo's house. With the wedding being here tomorrow, there's much to do here tonight. Adiel, be vigilant, I beg you.
God in my trouble. Soldiers in Miami painting, or sometimes like a piece of a bottle. And sometimes fashion even dresses up like the great Hercules, in that dirty, wormy tapestry. The one who is caught seems almost as big as his coat.
I get this. I also get how fashion changes so quickly that a man's clothing never gets a chance to wear itself out. You're all bound up about fashion too. Otherwise, why would you stray from the story and babble on about it?
No, I'm not wrong, but I will tell you, I see Miss Margaret, the lady who was waiting on you tonight. I called her hero the whole time. She leaned out of her mission's bedroom and told me goodnight 1,000 times. But I'm telling this story for you. I mean, backtracking me and how my master, Don John, arranged for the prince, Claudio, and himself to witness this friendly encounter from the earth.
And I thought Margaret was hero.
Well, The prince and Claudio did, but the devil, my master, knew he was martyred. They believed this. They believed this because my master's testimony, which caused Hero to be doubted, but partially because of how dark and deceiving the night was, and mostly because of my villainous actions, which further confirmed Don John's doubts. Claudio went away in blaze and swinging Hero out the temple to shame her for what he discovered.
We charge you in the prince's name to stop!
Call up the Master Constable Dog Perry. We have recovered the most dangerous piece of lechery that was ever known in the Commonwealth.
I know this criminal. He wears a lock of hair.
Gentlemen, I'll bet he'll be forced to bring the point forward. Don't speak. We'll obey you to go with us.
Probably a very bad catch in this time.
Well, the valor is available, I bet. Let's go. Okay.